ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। वेलकम टू वैदिक हेरिटेज। वी लाइट द लैम्प एवरी डे इन एवरी हाउस होल्ड एंड मेनी लैम्प्स ड्यूरिंग दीपावली। डू यू नो व्हाई? देर आर मेनी आंसर्स टू दैट, स्पिरिचुअल, फिलोसॉफिकल एंड प्रैक्टिकल। इन दिस वीडियो लेट अस लुक एट द साइंस बिहाइंड दिस प्रैक्टिस। मॉडर्न साइंस हैज टॉट अस अ लिटिल अबाउट द एनर्जी वर्ल्ड, the one that is not visible to us. We know about magnetic and electric energy, radio and microwaves. And although we do not see them, we believe that these waves exist because of the gadgets which help us use them. And there may be many more forces that we are yet unaware of. Indian scriptures talk about many such energies which are unknown to Western science. The Deepam or lamp also emits waves other than visible light. The scriptures say that when a lamp is lit, the rajasic or activated energy emissions from the deepam move outward in three dimensions into the surroundings, transforming the non-materialized or inert energy called nirguna kriya lahari into rajasic or dynamic waves of positive energy called saguna kriya lahari, which form a sheath of protection. Agni, fire, is one of the panchabhutas or prime elements of creation. The flame is the Agni element in the Deepa, which thus purifies the immediate surroundings. If you have ever sat in a room with just a lamp in front of you, you can experience the effect these waves have on our mind. They bring a feeling of serenity and well-being. Skanda Purana says, Deepa flame is better than fire, sun or moonlight. The mellow fire in the lamp sends out diffused light which travels beyond the purview of the eyes and creates a bubble of divinity all over one's home, which is an invitation to the gods to visit and a deterrent for negative forces. It is mentioned in Sri Agastya Rishi's Brahma Rahasyam that the vibration which emerges from the lamp will work as a three-dimensional vastu protector, securing the surroundings against negative energies. This is the reason that we also light lamps at auspicious gatherings and even social functions. Positive energy enhancer, which replenishes our physical and subtle bodies. Bestower of peace and prosperity, acting as a magnet to attract beneficial energies like peace, health, prosperity, etc. Therefore, we say that the Deepam invites divine light or energy, the energy of Goddess Lakshmi. She can be explained as the positive, nourishing energy of all creation. Lord Vishnu is the preserver or sustainer of all creation. And Lakshmi Devi is his energy that preserves and sustains. When we light the lamp, we invite her to pervade our homes and lives as a protective sheath of divine energy. Therefore, during auspicious and festive occasions like Deepavali, we light lamps to eliminate poverty from our homes, to keep away negative influences, and to invite all positive ones. You may ask, isn't divinity already all-pervasive? Isn't God everywhere? Why should I specially invite her? Let me explain using an example. Earth is suffused with oxygen everywhere. Life is impossible without it. But don't we see that forests and natural habitats are oxygen rich and polluted areas or locked up chambers have depleted or lower concentrations of oxygen? Similarly, divinity is everywhere. We can enrich an atmosphere with positive vibrations or let it be contaminated with negative ones. Thus, lighting a Deepa has benefits which cannot be achieved with an electric light or lamp. In fact, we can personally make out the difference by trying to meditate with a Deepa or an electric one and see the difference. The next important factor of the Deepa is the combustible substance, the oil. Why is that important? We are all familiar with aroma oil diffusers and mosquito repellents. The heat slowly vaporizes the liquid or solid which mixes with the surrounding. Similarly, when the oil in the Deepa burns with the wick, it gets dispersed into the environment. Shastras tell us that the waves emitted by the lamp differ depending on the type of oil used, and that there are specific results for the use of each oil. Specific to puja lamp, Agni Puran clearly states that only oil or ghee be used in the lamp, no other combustible substances. Ghee is more sattvic and has more spiritual benefits, while oils have more worldly benefits. Let us look at the benefits of ghee versus oil. A ghee lamp is sattvic, giving spiritual benefits. Oil lamp is rajasic, giving worldly benefits. Ghee lamp has a superior quality of protective sheath, while oil lamp has varying qualities of sheaths depending upon the oil used. Ghee activates the Atma Jyoti, the soul energy within the worshipper, whereas oil activates Manas Jyoti, the mental energy within the worshipper. Ghee significantly purifies the Anahata and the Manipura chakras in the worshipper, leading one upwards in spiritual growth. Oil purifies to a certain extent the Mooladhara and Swadhisthana chakras, healing fears, delivering prosperity and relief from worries of day-to-day existence. Ghee strengthens the sattva of the pranamaya kosha, energy body, and manomaya kosha, mental body, giving serenity, peace and happiness. Oil strengthens the rajas or the active quotient of pranamaya kosha, which gives the worshipper strength and energy, success and prosperity, but not calm. Let us now look at the benefits of each oil separately. Ghee, when made from a desi cow or a native cow milk, if prepared by the Vedic process, is the most sattvic and the best one for worship. It gives physical, mental and spiritual harmony. It attracts all positive vibrations like health, wealth, education, fame and goodwill. It also aids both worldly and spiritual goals. Pancha Deepam oil. It helps to nullify all evils, illnesses and negative thoughts. Brings knowledge, health, wealth, prosperity, happiness and fame. This is second best after cow's ghee. The Pancha Deepam oil is a blend of 5 pure oils. Each of these oils have their significance and should be mixed in the perfect ratio. It is especially used in Devi Parashakti worship. Many ready Deepam oils contain forbidden oils like rice bran, or are made in wrong proportions in order to economize. You can refer to the description below for the composition of this oil. Mahua Ilupa Ippa oil. It is also said to be next only to ghee in its goodness and powers. Sesame oil, gingerly or til oil is beneficial in the worship of all gods. It helps to eliminate doshas and repel evil spirits, eliminates long-term problems, removes obstacles from one's life, removes unforeseen dangers and inauspicious events, keeps snakes away by the smell, helps to please Lord Shani during Shani Mahadasha, Antar Dasha and in Sade Sati or the 7.5 year period of Saturn. Mustard oil too removes doshas related to planet Saturn and wards off diseases. Coconut oil pleases Lord Ganesha and it too bestows education, wisdom, spirituality, health, wealth, prosperity and removes obstacles from one's life. Castor oil bestows fame. It gives a fruitful family life, good relationship between wife and husband and also a devotional mindset. Palm oil, vegetable oils, rice bran oil, synthetic oil, cottonseed oil, etc. are not used because they have no good properties to offer. It is strictly forbidden to use groundnut or sunflower oil to light lamps. Lighting groundnut oil creates debts in the homes, leading to constant bickering for money. I hope knowing this information will help you enjoy our traditions more. Do check out the description for my earlier video on shlokas to chant while lighting a lamp. That video also talks in detail about the significance of lighting a lamp. Happy Deepavali to you and your family and friends. Do subscribe, like and share with others. Thank you for watching. Hari Om.